This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, anytime I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
What the voice is must be heard. Bigot, brave, and discriminate. The crimes which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. How the hell are you? I'm Jay, this is Casey.
What's up everyone? Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah. Well, day after Valentine's Day, but yeah. 2 days after.
All you lonely motherfuckers out there.
So here's hoping you got shot by the fat little baby in a diaper and got to do some fucking.
Yeah.
Everybody likes some fucking.
Happy pretend to like your significant other more than you actually do, day.
And remember, ladies, the day after was supposed to be steak and blowjob day, so hopefully you fulfilled your obligations as well.
Yeah.
If not, sorry.
And speaking of love, I seen John Wick 2 yesterday, and it took me all that I could to not pull a Pee Wee Herman in the movie theater. Fucking love that movie.
And if you tell me any of the plot points, I'm going to beat you beer mug.
It's all I'm going to say is Keanu Reeves, I love you. You can't act for shit.
No.
But you play the perfect character because you're a damaged, heartless piece of crap.
I absolutely love, my favorite part about the whole John Wick franchise is the criminal coins.
Love it.
You get criminal coins. It's almost like fucking Monopoly for bad people.
Like you do good at a game and like a Chuck E. Cheese and you get tickets.
Chuck E. Cheese tokens. You know, you can go spend your criminal coins on a criminal hotel and criminal beverages at the criminal bar.
Yeah, it was almost as good as the first, or maybe it is. I don't know. I'm still soaking it all in. It was just a great fucking movie. I loved it.
Would you say it's as good as Mad Max Fury Road?
I think it's better. I'm sorry.
I have a history with the Mad Max franchise.
I know, but it's so good, man. And there's this fucking bitch in it that's like, she's deaf, so she just knows sign language, and it's just awesome. I love it. It's such a great movie. I was just like...
All right, well, we'll talk some more movies here after we discuss our... Today we've got a goofy one from DuClaw Brewing Company out of Baltimore, Maryland. This is Sweet Baby Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. It reminds me of like an old Baptist lady down south. Like, oh, Sweet Baby Jesus, let me get you some food. There's the taters. You know, there's the roast beef. We have chickens in the backyard. Need some eggs.
Oh, honey, I know you have to try my peach cobbler.
It's a blessing. Yeah, I got a picture of it here for all you peeps out there that want to know what it looks like.
Is
chocolate
it?
Peanut butter stout. Or porter.
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 Last week we said we should probably pour this shit into a glass. You guys get an idea what it looks like. It's a very dark amber color.
Yes,
there very wasn't
dark.
Much of a head at all to it.
No, not at all. It's very, very, very dark. Yeah, we're going to start pouring them in the glass so you can actually... sort of look at it here in our nice little Kiss glasses.
I got the Love Gun one. That's my favorite Kiss album.
Yeah. Fucking Paul Stanley.
Shall we?
Yep. Ding dong.
That's...
Ooh.
I'm getting a lot of chocolate. I'm not really getting much of a peanut butter.
I do at first. I get the peanut butter at first, and then it just goes into like a roasty... like coffee-ish.
It's got that sweet maltiness.
Yeah, it's
roasty.
Very, very roasty. Like, makes me want to cuddle up on a fire with my, you know, loved one.
In other words, your hand.
Yes, exactly.
I saw a picture the other day, made me think of you.
What's that?
It was, you ever see them lace gloves that women wear when they're on their wedding?
Mm-hmm.
They said, I bought my girlfriend some lingerie for Valentine's Day.
That's perfect. That's perfect. Yeah, Jay was playing Quizzo yesterday, and his team name was, I was going to get late on Valentine's Day, but my hand fell asleep.
To be fair, that was our buddy Ron who came up with that one.
Oh, yeah. And speaking of Ron.
Who's going to be joining us next week on the show if all goes well, so you'll get to meet him.
He's about a 6'5", 6'6" Polish man. He's a big motherfucker.
Yeah, we big boys. Big tall guy, so he's gonna he gets to sit in our little bitch folding chair, and he's probably still going to be bigger than both of us, Dan.
Yeah, he's huge. Like we have like yeah, like you said, we just have like a little metal folding chair, and it's gonna be interesting him. His big ass sitting in front of, or in between us, so that's going to be interesting.
He also picked a beer for next week too, so that'll be a treat.
Yeah, because we wanted to ask him, or you know, what bring pick.
A he's beer. He's a beer guy too.
Yes, he's a very big beer guy. He loves shit like this. He'll. I've only ever seen him drink maybe not like like one or two beers in my whole life. That was it.
Yeah, that's when he's sick.
Yeah, he's a sick motherfucker, and the fucker can drink a lot too. Like, yeah, he's just so tall and big, he's just whatever.
Yeah, fucker never gets a hangover either. That shit's disgusting.
Yeah, I know. I just think his body's, like, ready to go in the morning, whatever.
So let's go ahead and be our local morning zoo and talk about the Grammys.
The Grammys.
Does anybody see the Grammys?
Fucking Jim Brewer, man. If anyone hasn't seen it, Jim Brewer is pissed off. He made a video. I saw it on Facebook at first, and then I got on YouTube and sent it to Jay last night because he's just so mad that James Hetfield's microphone didn't work. And plus, I guess they forgot to introduce him. Like, they didn't even introduce him.
They're a band who needs no introduction. Yeah, exactly. Jim Brewer needs to calm the fuck down.
I know. He was being like a little bitch in it. He's like, I want an apology. And I'm like, for what? Like, who do you think you are to get an apology from the Grammys? Like, who gives a shit? How do you know people still watch the fucking Grammys? But I saw that Odell won a bunch of shit. That's awesome. I love her. I'd fuck her. Jesus. But anyways, like, yeah, I guess they forgot to introduce Metallica. James Hetfield's mic didn't work, so then he had to share one with Lady Gaga cock. And, yeah.
You know what, though? She was badass in that performance. Not only did she, you know, bring the mic over, mm-hmm. and as soon as she realized that James's mic wasn't working, she came right over. And
yeah, and Jim Brewer, that was, like, the nicest thing he said. He was like, I got to give it to Lady Gaga for keeping her shit together. But
oh, yeah, she was fantastic. You know, she is one hell of a performer. If you don't like her music, that's fine. But the chick knows, the chick knows, the chick knows how to put on a show.
Yeah, it's because she's a whore.
She's certainly trying to get relevant again. Yeah. I wonder if she has a new tour coming up. Wait.
Because that's the thing. She said she quit, you know, the music business and everything because she had no private time or whatever. She said that.
Break.
I think, yeah, one of the quotes was, every time I answer my phone, I feel like I have to be business, like a business person. I just don't like that anymore. Like,
dude, I can respect that.
Yeah, she's like, I had to think, like, every time before I, you know, tweeted something or sent something to somebody and shit, and she was like, I'm sick of it. But yeah, we've been seeing a lot of her lately. But I'm not surprised to see her with Metallica. Like I said, she was actually like sort of doing punk shit and stuff when she was younger, and she there was a, I forget what band it was, some underground punk band or something like that. She came out and did a, like, she used to sing songs with them and shit, but I can't remember what it was.
Yeah, she's I respect her artistically. I do anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I think she's all right.
Oh, man. So roasty.
It is good stuff, though.
Yeah.
I wouldn't drink a lot of these. This is one of those other ones that I'd have one, enjoy it, and be done with it.
Yeah. It's actually pretty sweet. Like, it hurts my teeth, actually, but...
That's because you haven't seen a dentist in 10 years.
No, I seen one last year, actually.
Well, yeah, when you were forced to.
Yeah. I just have bad teeth. I don't know. It runs in my family. I think it's because I'm English.
You are English as fuck.
Yeah, I know. And look at his nose. You can see it from the side here. Look at that regal. Regal. But speaking of movies, yeah, so when I went to see John Wick, there was a couple trailers that I thought was cool that I wanted to talk about real quick. The Logan trailer was fucking awesome. I cannot wait to see that fucking movie. It just looks raw and fucking, oh, it's gory. And that's another thing. John Wick 2, I think, was a little bit more violent than the first one.
Really?
Yeah, it was pretty fucking
crazy. A movie where they shoot, like, 57 people?
Oh, dude, it's
there's
more
57,
than that.
Like, fuck.
It's the one part he's just, like, fucking going balls to the wall.
The first one is literally, like, 57 murders.
Yeah, and the one, like, I love guns. Like, guns do something to me that no woman ever can. And they call it a tasting, all right? This isn't a big plot line, but they call it a tasting, and he goes in, and he's like, I would like a tasting, and they show him all these guns, and he's like, I'm looking for some dessert. So he brings out, like, this $500,000 Vanelli shotgun. I'm like, oh. Like, Vanelli, like, oh, man, they make, like...
Does that go does that go in your Bananis?
Yeah, I know. I'd like some Vanelli
for roasting
custard. But Vanelli, they're just a great Italian company. They make a Vanelli shotgun. Of course they do, but...
I want some Vanelli syrup in my coffee.
Yeah. And they make, like, handmade shotguns that you can get for, like, over $1 million. They're pretty crazy.
Here, before we move on, though, I got the audio for the Jim Brewer thing. Okay. Let's play that quick so you can hear what a bitch he's being.
Yeah. He's being a little bitch.
Yeah, he's being a bitch.
I know. It's like you haven't been relevant in like 20 years. Why do you think people care right now?
Last time anybody cared what you had to say is when you were on Half Baked.
Oh, I love that movie. It's such a good movie.
If it decides to fucking load, we'll get it.
God, this fucking iPad needs to give it an apology.
Tonight on the Grammys, Metallica, the Grammys, where we celebrate artists. Unless you're Metallica, then we're going to screw up your intro, not even introduce you
as your own song,
and then turn your mic off, because that's what we do. We're the Grammys. Hey, show another promo. Don't go away, listeners.
Nobody turned their fucking mic off except for their own people.
Their tickets, because you made every one of them watch for over an hour just to wait for that nonsense. Pissed.
Why is he so mad? Like, I don't care.
I better get a huge hello. I am the head of the Grammys, and we're so sorry.
we're so sorry.
All right, I'm gonna cut it off there.
That's the funniest part, though, is just when he was making fun of him.
He goes on like this for almost 2 fucking minutes.
Yeah, he's being a little bitch. Like, I don't fucking care. Whatever.
First off, as far as that's concerned, the Grammys did not cut James's mic off. It's his own mic. It's those ridiculous reproduction, old school microphones with the metal casings. You know, they're his. He owns them. Mm-hmm. So it means somebody in his tech people fucked up is what happened. And somewhere floating around on the internet, if you look, there's a video of him throwing his guitar off the side of the stage to his tech in frustration. Well, and people are saying that he's throwing a temper tantrum. Well, no shit.
I know. You pay a fucking guy how much money to do one thing?
To like, make sure my shit works.
To make sure it works. And it just... And it wasn't even, I could see if it was a technical difficulty, but he forgot to plug his fucking mic in. Like, how do you do that? What if we just forgot to plug, or, you know, I accidentally stopped our video?
Yeah, what jackass would do that? God. Nobody's paying you, though.
Fucking jackass.
We did sell a shirt, though.
Oh, we did?
Yeah, we sold one shirt.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Keep buying our stuff.
Yeah, so keep supporting the channel. Thank you to whoever purchased that shirt, so...
God bless.
God bless you. Hey, and that leads us to our next thing. Hey, we have shirts. We have coffee mugs. We have hoodies. We have cell phone cases. Go to shop.spreadshirt.com/openlyhostileopinions. The link is in the video description below.
Yes.
Pick up some swag. We appreciate it.
All right. That reminds me. I'm a part of, you know, a bunch of like podcast groups, stuff on Facebook and everything. And a lot of people are bitching about this Blue Apron advertisement that they always hear. Have you ever heard of Blue Apron?
No,
it's
but
like
I
a food thing or something like that. Well, I was like, I've never heard of
it. Oh, the food delivery service. Yeah. Yeah, I've heard of them.
Well, I guess they sponsor a lot of podcasters, and all these people are like, I'm sick of Blue Apron thing. Well, I go in the movies last night, and before the movie started, there was a Blue Apron commercial. I was like, oh, this shit is everywhere.
We'd be happy if you Blue Apron, you want to sponsor us. We're all about it.
Yeah. And, back to the movie thing. New Power Rangers trailer.
Yeah, I watched it. I still don't understand the whole Power Rangers thing.
It's just, it's glory. Glory, hallelujah.
I mean, Bryan Cranston's playing Zordon, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
and Elizabeth Banks is playing Rita Repulsa, so that's pretty cool,
too. Yeah, and she looks badass. Like, there's this one part where she lands down in the middle of a street, and she just forms, like, asphalt monsters. And freaking, like, there was, like, a racial joke in it. Like, in the original series, there was the black guy, and he was the Black Ranger, and then there was Billy, that was the Blue Ranger. Well, in this...
Who was gay and got bullied on the set, by the way.
Yeah, no, that's another story. But in the movie, they're switched around. The black guy plays the smarter, geeky guy or whatever like that, and he's the Blue Ranger. Well, they fall into this pit, and they have these coins that they get, and he starts glowing black. And the other girl's like, I'm glowing pink, and I'm glowing blue. And he's like, I'm black. And he's like... No, you're not. So I was like, in a Power Rangers movie, a racial comment, like, that was awesome. And they were, like, swearing in it. They said ass a couple times and stuff. I was like, this might be good. I don't think it's for, like, little kids.
No, man. You got a hard-on for the Power Rangers.
Ah, it's going to suck. Fucking Kimberly. Pink Ranger back in the day, man.
Yeah, and then you got a iZombie. Yo, I'm pissed. That shit ain't coming back on until April.
Yeah, I know. How about it? That fucking bitch. That's okay. Thank God there's the internet and I can masturbate to that till then.
She's not even that good looking without the zombie makeup.
I think she is.
It's the pale whitening. What can I say? I like goth chicks.
Yeah, I think she's hot. That one episode where she dressed up as a scientist and she was normal and used her New Zealand accent. Then I found out she was a Power Ranger and my paper towel budget went up really high.
Paper towels?
Yeah, man.
Your dick must have calluses on it.
Oh, yeah. It did, man. I was flogging the bishop, man. Polishing that carrot, man. Oh, it was amazing. But other than that, trying to think. Those are the only two trailers that really stuck out, I think, that I saw that were really cool. But I love John Wick 2. I suggest go see it. I even know, like, for some reason, I don't know if it's the love story part of the movie. A lot of women like John Wick. Like, a lot.
It's because Keanu Reeves is hot.
Yeah, I know, but like you can't. It just doesn't mean. I think it's because it's the love story.
I ain't gay, but I squeeze his nipples once or twice.
I know he says like the funny thing is he says like three words in the whole movie. I'm not even joking.
That's good. It plays to his strengths as an actor. In other words, not acting.
I know, that's what I said. I love you to death, but you can't act for shit. That's why he does a good job at this.
Whoa.
Yeah, I'm back. And yeah,
he was just so bad in The Matrix.
I know, dude. I still.
I'm like the chosen one.
Where's the phone booth at so I can time travel? I thought that was actually pretty funny. There's phone booths in the Matrix movies. I was like, oh, Bill and Ted again. Okay.
It's like Bill and Ted's future adventure. That's what The Matrix was.
Yeah, that's about it. But yeah, so go and see it. I highly recommend it. Great fucking movie. Just try not to jerk off in a theater like I did.
And yet again, The Bornless Ones, go see it. It's in theaters now.
Yes.
If it's in a theater near you, it's an indie film. But definitely go check it out. Bornless Ones. That one's great, too.
All right. Moving right along, then. This was on the local news, actually. When I was doing Quizzo last night, someone brought this up to me.
Oh, good.
Yeah. It's. I thought it happened in Pennsylvania because of the news that covered it. But it didn't. It actually happened in Florida. But
of course it did.
Boy, oh God, please don't play an ad. Please don't play an ad.
You know how you can solve that problem?
Yeah.
Installing our data.
Yeah, we actually have a guest on our Wired Wednesday today that we're pretty excited. It's the CEO and, co-CEO?
CEO and the co-founder.
Yes.
Anyway, it doesn't matter because by the time this airs, you will have already seen it because it aired yesterday.
So boy 5 found chewing on used condom at school playground.
Oh, my God.
You imagine that, man. Billy, what is in your mouth?
I found some chewing gum. It tastes salty.
I didn't know they made salty chewing gum. I'm used to juicy fruit. Oh, I bet you it was juicy.
The only fruit that it was a banana.
So, police are investigating after a 5-year-old boy was found using a condom in his mouth at Florida Elementary School playground.
Of course it was Florida. Why wouldn't it be Florida? What else would it be?
It could be prostitution related.
You think?
I hate the fucking news. They're just like, oh, a horrible car crash today. No, it was great. It was delightful car accident. Fucking jackasses. I guess they're going to start patrolling more to see what they can find.
Security cameras might be a good idea too. Just putting.
Yeah, the child was rushed to the emergency room to get tests on for sexually transmitted diseases.
Oh man, could you imagine getting mouth herpes?
I know, dude.
Not just the cold sore kind, but like straight up fucking herpes.
I know, because that's the thing. Like that, if you get that, that kid has it the rest of his life. So when he's older, and you know he's trying to find a loved one or whatever like that, and maybe even he's like, yeah, I got herpes, and even if they stay with him. How are you going to tell that story?
Dude, they actually have dating websites nowadays for people who have STDs.
Oh, my God.
Hey, you know what? I think it's a good thing. If you
Here's a good thing. Close your fucking legs.
I'm just saying, if you got something that you can't cure, like herpes, and you want to hook up, and there's other chicks out there with herpes, like, you can't very well give it to each other if you already got it, so it's not a bad idea.
Jesus Christ. It's better. People having sex with herpes, it's probably like sandpaper rubbing together.
They can prevent the flare-ups, man.
Flare-ups, yeah.
Oh, man, you're going to make me lose my fucking breakfast.
Flare-ups. You're going to need a flare if you fuck a bitch with herpes and she doesn't tell you. You're going to need to signal for help with a flare.
Well, see, that's preventing people having sex with you that have herpes without telling you. That's the whole point of the dating sites.
I don't know. That's fucked up. Whatever. It doesn't surprise me, though. Like, what, a month ago we were covering a website where you can watch people sleep. And then there was
sleep creep.
Yeah, sleep creep. And what was that other thing where you could what was it you could do dating with contracts?
All dating's a contract.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a social contract if nothing else.
Yeah, it's like Van Water where he's asking what's her name for a date or whatever like that, and she's like, it's an interview. And he's like, first dates are interviews. It's one of my favorite lines.
Got a point there.
Yeah, it's I don't know. I love that movie. Did you ever see that movie?
Van Wilder, of course.
Oh, love it.
I've seen almost every movie ever. If you'll notice.
Notice what?
You know, that your friend's a movie buff.
Movie buff. Buff. Someone call a vet. These swans are sick.
Fuck's wrong with you?
That's another thing. Did you see that Cast Me Outside girl was back on Dr. Phil?
Oh, yeah. In fact, great segue, by the way.
Great segue. Yeah, she went back on. Dr. Phil's like, so I hear, that you've been pretty popular on the internet lately. And she goes, yeah, like Oprah Winfrey, I made you popular again. I was like, oh, my God, dude.
She made him popular. It's not that Dr. Phil's been sucking on Oprah's teat for 20 years.
I know, and that's why I thought it was funny that a 13-year-old girl knew that. usually girls don't even know the math problems these days, but she knew that.
She said to Dr. Phil, you were nothing before I came on this show.
That's so great.
Her mom's a piece of shit, apparently, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, a lot of information started coming to light. In fact, they refused to come back on the show without meeting a bunch of their mother's demands. I don't know what the demands are, but yeah, they had a list of demands for the show.
Yeah, you're really worried about your horrible teenage daughter and making her better. Mm-hmm. So you fucking be a diva and make her more of a bitch.
Yeah, she's a spoiled little brat. They were showing clips of her at the Turnabout Ranch, which you can't tell me that doesn't sound like a reformed gay camp.
Sounds like a rape center.
Yeah, the Turnabout.
You go Turnabout.
The Turnabout Ranch. You can't tell me that wasn't at least at one point a pray away the gay camp.
Oh, my God. That's
I promise you it was. Anyway, there's a fucking, there was horses and shit there, and her mom shows up in a fucking fur coat.
What?
You don't show up into a fur coat at a farm. You're probably going to offend one of the animals.
Your girl is a little spoiled cunt. I wonder where she gets it from. I couldn't fucking imagine. You fucking piece of shit. God. The people wonder. Like, I bet you there was actually really people, too, sitting there watching this going, I feel so bad for that mother.
Oh, I got into an argument with somebody the other day online, and it was pretty funny. you could probably
fight with someone online. That's weird.
Well, you can probably find out if you log on to our social networks. I believe it was on Google+. I got into this debate with some bitch who was talking about her. It's like, oh, she needs loving and understanding. Like, no, she needs a swift kick in the ass.
She's got too much loving and understanding. That's why she's a fucking cunt like she is.
Right, and this girl tried to explain to me that, oh, she's been hit too much in her life. That's the way she is. That's why she is how she is. Like, no, she's like she is because she's a
people like
spoiled
that,
little bitch.
People like that have never been through suffering. When people are that fucking stuck up and pieces of shit, they haven't been through anything hard in their life.
No, people learn to appreciate what they got when they go through some shit.
And that's why people are saying, oh, America's full of a bunch of stuck-up cunts. We need like a natural disaster or something to happen to bring people back. I'm not wishing upon people, but something like that would happen to bring people back down to the roots and realize that they're not so big. It's fucking ridiculous. People are just such fucking cunts.
Yeah, and then those people are just the example of what's wrong with the world. You got to kick your kids' ass if they do wrong. You know what? I get compliments on how well-behaved my children are. You know why? Because when they do wrong, I whoop their ass.
You gonna learn. I know. You don't see you going on fucking Dr. Phil and shit
no.
like that.
When my kid doesn't listen, I spank him. I'm not saying I punch him in the mouth or anything like that, but I'll spank her ass when
there was actually an episode. I forget what it was. It's a cop show. and I can't remember the name of it, but they go into this call where this kid calls the cops on his mom.
Yeah.
And says that he was getting child abuse. Well, they look at the kid and everything like that, and he has a little bruised bum.
So and he got his ass kicked.
Yeah, so he got his ass kicked. So the cop goes, so what happened? She goes, he disobeyed me, so I beat him with the belt. And the kid's like, so the guy was like, is that true? He goes, yeah, it's child abuse. And he pulls the kid aside, and he, like, rips into this kid. He goes, that is not child abuse.
No, that's called parenting.
Yeah, that's what he said. He goes, it is called parenting. And I was, like, actually surprised to see that on, like, a – it's a popular cop show, and I can't remember the name of it. But, like,
I don't know, but that's a good – you can't be your friend, your kid's friend. You have to be their parent. A parent,
exactly. Yeah.
The friendship part comes older, later on down in life when they're older.
When they're older and, you know, they're buying their first house, they're getting married, that's when the friendship part comes
They'll come back and they'll come and respect you. Yeah. You know, they'll ask for your advice because that's what happens.
Yeah, I'd say like in my mid-20s. It just hit me all of a sudden how bad I treated my mom.
Oh, yeah. We all have that realization at some point.
I think I was, like, laying in bed watching TV or something. It just was like, boom. It hit me. I was like, holy fuck, I was a bad kid.
Like, damn, I was a little bastard.
Yeah, and I was like, my mom didn't even drink. How'd she do it? Like, my mom never drinks. She smells it. She gets drunk. And I just like, holy fuck, man, I was a horrible kid.
Do you think Kathy still watches the show?
No, definitely not.
I'm pretty sure we scared her off after the first couple episodes. I think
she checks up on it. Like, she's really like, well, she's a mother. Of course, she's proud. But like
mine's like, you better not talk about me on the show.
Yeah, like, yeah, Jay's mom hates this. But my mom's just like, you know, she's proud of me, I guess, but she doesn't like the language. she used to be like a Sunday school teacher and all this shit, so she's like, whatever. But actually my sister, I guarantee, doesn't watch the show, but she knows I do it. And she was spreading the word at her work, and she told me that a doctor liked us, actually. I don't know if she's bullshitting.
A doctor?
Yeah. So
we're moving up in the world. We are endorsed by the American Medical Association. Yeah. By a member of the American Medical Association.
A female doctor, though. Like it's surprising enough that it's a doctor, but a female doctor.
They probably like me, because I'm not the one who sits here and shit talks them.
Whatever. Well, that's the thing. Like, you know, I talk about women and shit, talk feminism and stuff like that.
To be fair,
but a doctor does good, so she's not going to believe in feminism, you know. She does good for herself.
To be fair, you're talking about skanks. Yeah. You're not talking about normal women.
Yeah, but my sister was like, yeah, I told a doctor about your show. I was like, how'd that come? She goes, well, she just seems like she would like it. And I guess she watched just on her lunch break as much as she could. And she told my sister, she's like, oh, I love it. She's like, that's my kind of humor. So if you're watching that out there, doctor, thank you.
Thanks, doc. Share with all your doc friends.
What's up, doc?
We don't know who you are. We give you a shout out, but actually you probably get in trouble. So anyway, thank you.
Yeah, you probably would. I forgot about that.
Speaking of which, I should probably say, damn, you should have gotten your fucking party poppers. We have crossed 100 subscribers now. We were at, last I looked, over 120.
Ah, shit. I forgot about that. That's why I bought party poppers for moments like this. Shit.
We need to start keeping a box around here, because you know what? We need one of them for
I'm just going to make a, like a break in case of celebration glass on the wall here and put party poppers in it.
But yeah, we have crossed over the 120 subscriber mark, which is super awesome.
Yeah.
So now our URL is youtube.com/c/openlyhostileopinions. I was gonna go with channel, but okay. I don't know what the C is all about.
Monster jumped in my head there.
I don't know what the C is all about, but we're youtube.com/c/openlyhostileopinions. If anybody would like to get in on the visual aspect of our show,
it not stands that we're for that come pretty. And see our show, or we'll fucking kill you. Are we joking?
Openly hostile opinions does not endorse any kind of violence against our viewers.
No, I'll fucking kill you. But anyways, yeah, we were, I think it was Thursday or Friday, we were like 99, and then it hit 100, and we were like, oh shit, you know, like, we can't believe it happened. And then it just like threw up to like,
Jesus Christ, Casey.
120. And so I just want to personally thank you for everyone that's, you know, supported us. 100 subscribers. We were surprised.
We never thought we'd get more than like 30.
I know. So thank you all. I do appreciate it. You know, out of the little bit of kindness I have left in my heart, thank you.
Let me see what the actual total is right this moment on our channel. It's 132.
Oh, shit, man.
So we have gone up quite a bit. So
moving
I just.
Moving on up, moving on up.
To the east side. So in all honesty, though, seriously, for each and every one of you, thank you very much for being a subscriber. Thank you for supporting us.
Yes.
Please share. Hit that thumbs up button when you like what we do. It helps us out a lot. Share with your friends, your family. If you haven't subscribed yet, you should. We try really hard to be funny for you people. Love us. Please love us. We want you
love
to love us.
Love me, say that you love. I don't know why these songs are popping in my head.
Because we're nostalgic.
Yeah, that's true.
And music sucks.
Yeah, it does.
Speaking of which, I should probably bring that up. One of our viewers, Jesus Christ, let me pull this up. One of our viewers.
Yeah, we're horrible with names.
I know. He's going to be happy we said his name on the air again because he said so before. But I was in a lovely conversation with one of our viewers who is Malcav1379. As you recall correctly, last week we were bitching about the state of music and he gave us a couple of bands to listen to. Mm-hmm. Some of them I've already listened to for quite a bit, like Red Fang and Clutch and Mastodon. Love Red Fang, love Clutch. Mastodon, I can take or leave.
Yeah. Mastodon is very talented. I just never got into them.
They're really good. I like stoner metal and whatnot. Doom metal. It's good. It's just I don't know. Anyway, he gave us a couple of suggestions, and we got a chance to listen to a couple of them. Let's talk about a couple of those. One is Baroness. I've actually heard a couple of their songs. Never knew who they were. So they're very good. They're another stoner band, but they have like almost sort of a poppy kind of hook to it in the choruses.
Like no, I'm joking.
Not quite. But their song actually almost won a Grammy.
Really?
Yeah, it was in the Best Metal Performance, which Megadeth actually ended up taking away with Dystopia.
Oh, yeah, that's we want to bring that up real quick.
Yeah. That was great. That one wasn't aired because, of course, it wasn't, but you can find the clip on YouTube.
This is just hilarious.
I feel so bad for Dave Mustaine because that motherfucker's been trying so hard.
To get under the shadow, away from the shadow of Metallica.
And 12 tries to win a Grammy. 12! And he finally wins one.
This is so embarrassing.
And the house band started playing Master of Puppets.
He finally wins a Grammy. He's trying to get out of the shadow of Metallica, and the fucking orchestra plays Master of Puppets for his acceptance speech.
Oh, that poor bastard. I feel so bad for him.
Oh my god, dude. I would be flipping balls. I'd be like, motherfucker, I can't get away from him.
90% chance we're going to end up with a copyright flag on this one, so...
I don't know. It might not because of the. It's not showing the video, but who fuck
knows? Well, it's the audio, but here, listen to this shit. So they're going to announce. Margaret Cho is the presenter. I love Margaret Cho. She's hilarious.
Best metal performance.
What's the Cho about?
Baroness. Gojira.
Yeah, Baroness.
Korn, Megadeth.
Yeah, for their song Grisly. Shock Me. I shared that video the other day on our socials, so if you haven't checked that out, do so.
Gojira
they're good.
Gojira got nominated?
Yeah, Gojira got nominated.
And the Grammy goes to Dystopia Megadeth. Yeah!
Yeah, which is,
she does the metal or shut up, bitch.
That poor bastard. He's been trying so hard.
Oh, that fucking sucks. Oh, man.
You know, complete credit to Dave Mustaine. He didn't even say anything about it.
Really?
He's definitely grown up, because if this was 20 years ago, he'd be like, what the fuck?
No, he probably would have just went up to the mic and be like, what the fuck.
He was laughing as he was walking up, so he thought it was absurd.
Yeah, he'd be like, you done messed up, A.A. Ron.
Damn it, A.A. Ron.
He looks down, the conductor's name tag says A.A. Ron. Yeah, that just fucking sucks. Like, oh. But he was probably so happy he won a Grammy. He's like, you know what? I don't fucking care. Whatever.
All right, so we're going to talk about these bands that Malcav sent to us. Baroness, like I said, they're good. Check them out. I shared a video on our socials because I was really impressed by the song Shock Me. It's so catchy, but it's still sludgy, stoner metal-y. Mm-hmm. I love it. I found a new band that I'm going to probably pursue their albums. I listened to the entire album Purple. It was very good. He also shared one with us called Sayor. S-A-O-R. I guess it's the Gaelic word for free. is what it means.
Freedom!
The fact that this shit is not the soundtrack to Braveheart is just a crime against
humanity.
Is this
the band you were showing me? We were listening to it together?
Well, we listened to a couple of these together, but this is the one...
I know, but one stuck out of my mind as like this fucking, like, the riding unicorn.
Oh, no, no, we'll get to that. We'll get to that. No, this band was... they play, like, Scottish folk music. And they have, like, the heavy guitar and the heavy drums and shit in the background underneath all the Irish bagpipes. They've got fiddle, all that shit. It's actually really cool. They have very little vocals, though. Mm-hmm. And what they do have is so distorted, it's basically just part of the ambiance, which is really neat. I liked it. I'd have to be in the mood for it, but I liked it.
Good.
So there's that one. That's pretty cool. There's one called Caledon Brood. That was really atmospheric, really spatial kind of music. It's definitely, at least what I heard was instrumental. It's not my thing, but it would make a great soundtrack to a movie. Seriously, it sounds like a horror movie soundtrack. It was good, it just wasn't my thing. And then there's Power Wolf. This is a German power metal band, and these guys are so over the top. I love it. I have to be in the mood for power metal, but it's so cheesy, and I fucking love it. These people are the kind of guys who have never been photographed when they're not standing in the middle of a forest.
Yeah, I know, dude. Like, and like Jay was showing me, because he was looking into them when we were listening to him. The one guy actually made his guitar out of termite-eaten wood.
I don't know that he made it himself, but it was termite-damaged wood. It was actually really cool.
Yeah, and I was like, he probably got that in the photo shoot they were taking.
Yeah, they probably cleaved a tree, a mighty oak in twain.
Like they called down Odin and like took
with a broadsword.
Like it just listen to it. It sounds like you're riding a rainbow fucking unicorn into battle.
Oh my god,
it is so great. It's just so amazing. I love it. It's fucking awesome. And like, thank you for all your, you know, feedback on the music and everything.
Yeah,
because
you know what, anything at this point that's a fucking different sound than what I'm used to, I'm happy with.
Yeah, and Jay were listening to it together, so thank you for, you know, the recommendations and everything like that. We appreciate it. And anyone else that has, you know, want to talk about movies, Jay's sex life.
You know, Powerwolf does a pretty bitchin' Iron Maiden cover, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they do a really good job with it.
Well, they're great musicians, and they're just fucking insane.
they're power metal, man.
Yeah, it's just insane. Yeah, but anyone else wants to, like, talk about anything else, we're up for it.
All right, let's just see if I can get away with it. We're going to get a copyright claim on this fucking video.
Just play, like, 5 seconds.
Yeah, I will. Here, let's skip right to the middle and use... Listen to this shit. Come on, that's badass. Okay, yeah, I wanna listen to some more of that, but I can't. I don't want to get us in trouble. And here's the other one, Baroness Shock Me.
Baroness Shock Me.
Yeah, Baroness is the name of the band. Shock Me. Shock Me is the song. There, let's get going. See, it's kind of poppy, but it's...
I like the bass in it.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Very distinct. Oh, that's like fucking In the Garden of Eden type thing.
Oh yeah.
In the Garden of Eden.
I'm not gonna play the whole thing because I don't want to get a copyright claim, but that shit's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can pull up one of the Sayer songs. That one was kind of cool too.
Sayer what?
You guys can get an idea of it. All this shit's available on YouTube. I'm not playing anything you can't get a hold of.
Yeah. And like we were saying, if anyone wants to talk about movies, books, or anything, just fucking, you know, give us a holla. Cash us outside. How about that?
Sayer might be a little bit more difficult. Wait a minute.
You know what's fucked up, Jay? You know what's fucked up?
What's that?
I forgot to rate Tay's beer.
We'll do it.
No, I'm good. Shit. I'm going to give it fucking... 3.5 lonely bachelor pieces of shit out of 5.
Dude, for that one, you have to put up that picture of the fucking Cupid getting shot.
I actually wanted to make a Valentine's Day overlay today, but I ran out of time. And it was going to be like the Cupids like just laying all over with their heads missing and shit.
Yeah, normally I'm the overlay guy, and I just didn't feel like this was warranted. Who gives a
fuck about Valentine's Day? Whatever. There's just going to be a lot of people fucking today.
Like, I feel bad for the maids at hotels tomorrow.
I know. They have to clean all the sheets. Ugh.
Listen to this shit. Fucking bagpipes and shit going on right now. See, there's very little vocal. It's just...
Whoa, whoa. I actually listened to a band like that one time, and it was just, the music video was them playing like these fucking little fiddles, like hand fiddles. I don't know what the fuck they
mandolins?
Were.
Mandolins?
I know, they weren't mandolins. They were fucking weird. Like, I'd never seen an instrument like it before, and they just like lit a cornfield on fire. And that was the video. And it was so out of control.
I'm cool with that.
Yeah, like they were just playing in a cornfield and they lighted it on fire. I don't know, it was awesome.
Cornfield fire lighting is okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, like we said again, yeah, please interact with us, whatever. We're so lonely.
Yeah, so, yeah, those are some of the bands that he showed us. So, thanks for giving us a heads up. That shit's pretty... I especially... Baroness is something I'd listen to a lot. Mm-hmm. One that I wouldn't listen to unless I'm in the mood for, but I would get so excited when I do is Powerwolf. That shit is just so...
Yeah. You ever want to be in a good mood, just listen to that. So.
I fucking guarantee that at least in one of their videos, somebody, for those of you on the audio podcast, I apologize, you can't see what I'm about to do, but at least one guy's going...
Yeah, he's doing the metal.
And, yeah, the somebody metal. Does the face grab, the face mask grab.
Like Backstreet Boys used to do back in the day.
Those guys actually like wear fucking corpse paint and shit, which is strange. Yeah, no, we for looked a power at a picture band.
Of them, and they're all like fucking decked out. They look like, I don't know, fucking Satan's turds.
They look like they're all going to a Renaissance fair at any given moment. Yeah.
I'm going to a Renaissance fair again. I went to one when I was young, but I don't remember it. Like, because I remember little bits and pieces, but I don't remember a lot of it, and I want to go to another.
Ren fairs are fun.
Yeah.
So one of the only places you can go and buy a big fucking turkey leg.
I know, that's what I'm getting, a turkey leg, and I'm going to get me some wenches.
I got to wait till my beard grows back out again. I'll go as a Viking.
Yeah, I'm going to be considered a servant or a pleb because I can't grow a beard.
Plebe.
Yeah, plebe.
Plebeian.
You pleb. You
surf.
All right, so got another story we're going to cover here. I think this is fucking hilarious, and this sounds like something I'd do if I was a woman.
Of course you would.
Cartwheeling teacher arrested for indecent exposure.
Oh, you know, I heard about this.
Did you?
I was going to talk about it last week, and I forgot.
A substitute teacher in northern Oklahoma was arrested on an indecent exposure complaint after reporting doing a cartwheel in front of her students while wearing a skirt with no undergarments.
Somebody recorded it with their cell phone.
Wait, there's a video?
No, they didn't release the video, but supposedly that's how they got caught.
Oh, man. That sucks.
What kind of a little bitch fucking would turn her in?
I know. Like, what the fuck, man? And I'm just curious.
Where were all these teachers when I was in school?
Like, when did it hit her that she remembered she didn't wear underwear? Like, was the air conditioner on above her and just was like... Like mid cartwheel.
Why does it smell like trout all of a sudden?
She's like mid cartwheel, and all of a sudden she feels this like breeze. Yo,
you think it whistled?
Yeah. And she looks down. She's like, oh no. Like mid cartwheel, she realized she fucked up.
Fucking sounds like somebody blowing on a joke.
It was like. And after she did it, the fucking old like history teacher comes in. He was like, the tea's done? Because he thinks it's the tea whistling.
Fucking just sounds like this.
And the one kid in like the corner named Timmy thinks it's like train day and gets all excited. He's like, is that a train?
Oh my god, I saw a vagina. How old were they?
I don't know. I think it says fifth grade.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, she was 34 years old and was arrested. Actually spent a jail until Wednesday morning. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, my God. My kid's in fifth grade.
Yeah. I don't know.
My oldest daughter's in fifth grade. Okay, yeah. Yeah, by the way, what is it with fucking fifth graders with cell phones? Some of my oldest daughter's friends have cell phones.
I know. I don't get it. And that's like, if I had kids, they wouldn't get it until they're 18. I don't give a fuck, whatever.
I don't know about that. I might give her one sooner than that just because I'll tell you, there were a few times when I was like 15 mm-hmm. and it would have come in handy.
Yeah.
Especially when they're driving.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm not a parent, so I don't really fucking have much to say about it, but I just, it's weird.
I have my concerns about it, but I'm definitely getting one of them fucking things that I can track everywhere.
Yeah. And like, I just wait tables.
You got GPS your ass.
Yeah. And I wait tables and stuff like that. And cell phones are just annoying, especially when kids have them, because like, you're trying to give them the food and they'll have these huge iPads. You're trying to set the food down. And it's like,
you should be happy because you're the kind of guy who gets angry whenever a kid starts crying in a restaurant.
Yeah. Don't bring your fucking kids to a restaurant, you fucks.
For the record, the restaurant he's referring to has the slogan "Food, Friends, and Family."
Yeah, as long as it's not your kids.
It's a family restaurant.
I don't give a fuck.
Speaking of that, I was at the bar the other day. I gotta put this out publicly because it was part of our wager. One of our buddies who hangs out at the bar named Dave. Dave and I made a bet. So I try not to get very political because my opinions do not generally jive with the salt of the earth type people we have out here. We'll
call
it
salt of the earth.
A little rough around the edges. Little
is that a metal band album?
Yeah,
salt of the earth.
No, but Salt the Wound was, and they're a great band. Yeah. Anyway, so my political opinions don't generally jive, but anyway, we got into a debate about Donald Trump's fucking wall. So I said, there's no fucking way. It's never going to happen. It'll never be done. So I made a wager with Dave that if that wall is built to completion from California to Gulf of Mexico, built to completion, I will walk around for an entire week, including on this show, with a T-shirt that says Dave Adams is the smartest motherfucker I know.
I didn't know about this. Yes. This is a Trump, please build that wall.
So if that's the case, if that wall gets built to completion, you'll all get to make fun of me for a week.
What will change? I know, we always make fun of you.
Yeah, whatever. I'm the sane one on this show.
I'm normal. Everyone else is crazy. How about that?
Cash me outside. How about that? Yo, we got away from that subject too fast. Here's something else I want to mention about that. Her dad is a cop.
It just gets better. It just gets better. It just fucking gets better. Yeah, he's probably never home because he's always working. Then you got fucking douches, whatever her fucking name is, coming out with a fur fucking coat. You wonder why your kid's fucked up, you fucking cunt. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, her dad is a fucking police officer. Can you believe that?
Oh my God, that's ridiculous. Whatever. This is why I use a condom. I don't want fucking kids because they'll turn to cast me outside.
Yeah. His name is Ira Peskowski. That is holy fucking Eastern European as hell.
Fuck, man.
Polish as shit.
Does he wear, like, when he's not a cop and he's not wearing his uniform, does he wear full Adidas jumpsuits?
I don't know, but look at him.
Oh, my God.
He looks like Mr. Clean.
I bet, yeah, he does. I bet he's so depressed about his daughter.
It's definitely one of those situations where the bitch lives with her mother.
Yeah.
Like, they're definitely divorced.
Yeah, and she's like, you know, the mother was trying to be like, oh, let's be friends. Let's get our nails done and stuff. It's like, no, you make that bitch clean her fucking room.
And that fucking ridiculous haircut. She has that, I'd like to speak to a manager at Walmart.
Yeah, I know, she does. Fucking cunt.
You know what it reminds me of? You ever see John and Kate plus 8 before they split up and she had that fucking ridiculous haircut of hers? Now she's all divaed out and glam, but
she's still around. Like, she's not dead yet.
She has enough money from to help pay for nannies and shit.
Of course she does.
You know what, though? Here's the deal with her. If you ever watch that show, John and Kate Plus 8, or I guess it's Kate Plus 8 now. You know what? Her husband, I used to root for the guy because he just seems so tired of all this craziness of all these children. But you know, he's a piece of shit, and he fucked around on her and everything. You know, she doesn't seem like the nicest human being in the world, but you don't fuck around on people.
Of course he did. They had how many fucking kids?
Like, I think he's obviously done enough.
Like, everyone was so shocked when they broke up. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? One kid will ruin a marriage. They had 8. Imagine how big her nipples are from the 10. Suction. Oh, 10. Holy fuck, yeah, fuck that.
They had 8 in
fuck, yeah, fuck that, man. He was probably fucking sewer lids. Like,
well, was it 10? I don't know. Either way, they had all the twins, and then they had 2 other kids.
Oh, okay. Like, kids are fucking horrible. They'll ruin a marriage. They will. Like, no wonder. Like, everyone was so shocked. I'm like, do people know how bad kids are? Like, they'll fucking ruin your day.
Why do I let you babysit my kids?
I was actually really nice to your kids. They loved me because I...
let them do whatever they wanted. Yeah, I
like
know.
Throw mud on my car and grass, but whatever. And they called it the horsey game. Had nothing to do with horses, but whatever. It was an old like 91 Ford Tempo. I didn't give a fuck. If it made the kids smile, throw mud on my fucking car. I don't give a shit. And that's why I make a great babysitter. I'm a kid myself.
I actually had to tell Casey that, like, don't give them all the junk food they want.
Yeah.
Because they were horrible. They had stomach aches for the next 2 days.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I just let them eat whatever they want and do whatever they want. And when Jay's wife came home, they started grabbing stuff because they don't ask me. They just do it. And they went to go and grab stuff, and his wife's like, no. They were like looking at her like,
oh, my God, rules have arrived yet again.
Rules again. And they're like, they were wearing, I think, their school clothes or something. They're out just playing in the mud and shit. And I'm just like, are those your school clothes? They're like, no. And I'm like, are you sure?
It wasn't a big deal. I got all the stains out.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. I just, whatever. I'm a kid myself. Whatever. Yeah, kids have to explore. They have to explore. Yeah. That's why I just, you know, if they're climbing a ladder to go and, you know, onto the roof, I just let them go.
You know, and kids have to be explored, apparently, if you're a member of the Sandusky family.
I know. I saw that. I was like, runs in the family.
For those of you who aren't aware what I'm talking about, if you remember a couple of years ago, the whole Jerry Sandusky.
I saw that when I was taking a shit the other day. I was like, his brother got caught.
No, it was adopted son.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So Jerry Sandusky is the guy from Penn State who is turning tight ends into wide receivers in Penn State. Well, apparently his son, adopted son, just got busted for multiple counts of child sex abuse.
I wonder why he adopted him.
He was arraigned on charges Monday afternoon in Bellefonte. His mother, Dottie Sandusky, was also at the district magistrate's office. They started an investigation in November of 2016 after a child claims he received text messages from Sandusky, including some that asked for naked photographs. So anyway, they were shared with the child's father, who then notified the police. That guy must have had the patience of a saint, because most fathers would go cut the dude's dick off and feed it to him.
Yeah, exactly. Sacrifice it.
So according to the criminal complaint, a second child was also abused dating back to 2013. So Sandusky is prohibited from contact with minors. Speaking of child molesters, man, there's a serious fuck up with our justice system that I want to talk about. You know, the pedo down the street we refer to on occasion, you know, he had admitted to this, pled guilty back in, April?
Something like that, yeah. It's been a while.
Back in April of last year, and here we are heading out. He still isn't in prison yet.
Yeah.
You plead guilty to it, and you're still walking around free.
Yeah.
And he was at very small community. He was at the school.
I know, for children's, like, Christmas
party. It was the children's Christmas pageant. He was there. I'm just like, and because I'm a big pussy, of course, I didn't say anything.
But it's like,
But out of a room full of 100 parents, nobody said anything. And we all know. This is a community of less than 500 people. We all know what happens at any given moment.
And then it happens again, and then people are like, oh, woe is me. What the fuck did you think was going to happen?
What is what is so fucked up with our justice system that if you fucking plead guilty to touching kids inappropriately, are you still doing out nearly a year later before you go into prison?
I and that's the thing. And, you know, with this Sandusky thing like that, that just shows you how much it actually happens.
Oh, yeah.
I think child molestation is so – actually, I think it's a really popular thing. We just don't hear about it.
I don't know if I want to use the word popular.
I don't know what else the word to use, so that's what you're getting. Microwave for 5 minutes, open, eat, let sit for two. that's what word you're getting, because I don't know what else to use it. But it's just – there's so many people – like, I've had friends that got caught doing it, and I never thought they would do it. The one's in jail now because of it. And that because he tried to kill someone over heroin money. Yeah, exactly. And then that, but he tried to kill someone over heroin money, but whatever. And then, like, I found out that people that have been close to me my whole life were molested when they were younger. It happens a lot more than people think. And it's like, this is why I get so pissed off when people are like, oh, you know,
men shouldn't be child molesters. Men shouldn't be rapists. There is always going to be rapists. There is always going to be child molesters. Learn self-defense. Buy a fucking gun. Someone touches you, blow their fucking genitals off. Good night, I'm done.
All right, then.
Stick up for yourself. Don't be like fucking Donnie Darko. I love that movie where Kurt Russell's in there trying to sell his book. Like, oh, you know, have a good life. And he stands up and he's like, you know what? This is the biggest fucking sack of garbage I've ever heard. He's like, you getting sick of bullying? I don't know. Take karate. Maybe lift some weights. And next time he does it, you kick him in the balls. Stick up for yourself because no one else.
Words to live by.
I love that movie. It's so true. People will bullshit you your whole life. And it's just, you have to stick up for yourself. Buy a fucking gun.
You done? did you unleash your rage?
Yes, I unleashed my rage. And then after that, Cheeto that looks like Harambe sold for $100 or $100,000 on eBay.
Of course it was. We have a fucking place where you can get crowdfunding to make potato salads.
Yeah, I don't really have anything on it. I just thought that was interesting to bring up. It was a Cheeto. It looked like Harambe. Someone bought it for $100,000. Like, who? I wish I had that kind of fucking money. Just like, just blowing shit like that. Like, I remember when eBay first got popular, someone bought a toasted cheese sandwich that looked like Jesus was in it. You remember that?
Who wouldn't?
You're like, I want that. Was it pepper jack cheese? That reminds jack. Me. I bought pepper jack string cheese. Oh, it's so good.
Don't tell it to the fat guy during the show. We're going to have to take a momentary break.
Cheese. I don't eat a lot of cheese, but I love pepper jack for some reason.
Well, you don't need a whole lot of cheese because it turns your guts into a fucking
slip and slide. Yeah, I'm lactose intolerant, so I fucking shit my brains out. Like, it's fucking, like, god-awful.
It is god-awful.
Yeah, it's, whatever.
Hey, so a quick plug here. I want to give a little shout-out to those of us who are out there listening on the audio podcast. You can find us on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, iTunes Radio, iTunes Radio, TuneIn Radio. We're available on just about any podcatcher you can get us on, because most of them pull from the iTunes library, but those ones I know for a fact were a part of Pocket Casts. For those of you wondering why you would want to do that, a great way to listen to a podcast is to download it through one of the podcatchers. And just about everybody has an auxiliary port on their car stereo nowadays. It's a good way to listen back and forth on your way to work. We do an hour show every week. You know, if you got a 15-minute ride, it's a good way to kill time back and forth through most of your work week. That's what one of our Patreons, Shane Hartle, does. So thank you to Shane for that. So those of you who are looking for a reason to do that, that's definitely one of the ways you can do it. There's a lot of free ones out there. Some of the paid ones are nice. Like I said, Pocket Casts. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of nice features, but it's going to cost you a couple bucks.
Yeah. We're free. Our bodies are free. And we also have, like we said, we have Wired Wednesdays that we're going to try to do more.
Those are video only, though. They're available on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/C/openlyhostileopinions.
Come and see us. Yes. And then I've freed up some time during the week because there's other stuff that I want to do. I want to start doing a movie review show. It's not going to be like, you know, I'll give it to you. It's just going to be me basically ranting about movies and how they make me feel. It's not going to be too, like, strict or anything like that. I don't think I'm really going to rate them. It's just I'm very passionate about movies, so I want to start talking about them. And it's not going to be just newer movies. It's going to be older movies, you know, not so newer movies, and just things that I enjoy. It was basically nerd out over them, whatever. Get some nerd sweats going.
Oh, can I be on occasionally?
Yeah.
I like movies.
Yeah.
Obviously. Kind of a movie guy.
Yeah, kind of movie guy.
All right.
And we'll eat Pepper Jack's string cheese while we do it.
I don't think anybody wants to see us eat anything on camera.
Pussy.
You want to go make a sex tape and leak it? We might get some publicity off of that.
I know. How about it?
All right. I got one more thing to go before we go off into that cold, dark night. So there was a CNN host who fucked up.
What do you do now? Did he do a cartwheel with no underwear on?
No, he just... Let me give you a little background information. There's nothing I hate more than somebody who says something that they feel and then backpedals later when there's a backlash over it. It's so fake. It's so stupid. And people buy it, and you're all stupid if you buy it. You know, like, oh, he should apologize. Why?
I know.
What good is that going to do you?
That's like when Tiger Woods got caught, you know, fucking all those girls and shit. And be like,
I'm terribly sorry.
Yeah, it's like, I don't see what the problem is.
You were rich. Like,
you did what you're going to do.
That's what normal people do when they have money. They
and,
fuck
and
everything.
You know what? If you say or do something offensive to somebody and then you go later on backpedal it, it's all bullshit and we all know it's bullshit. You're just saying it to make everybody shut the fuck up for 5 minutes. You still believe what you said. Uh-huh. And so anyway, Chris Cuomo from CNN says the word fake news insult is equivalent of the N-word for journalists. And while I get the point he's trying to make, obviously people are pissed.
You don't say that, dude.
No, you don't say that.
I saw this like scrolling through like other news stuff, but I didn't realize that's what he said.
Yeah.
That is fucking hilarious.
Well, it's just anything people don't agree with right now, including our Cheeto in chief right now. Anything they don't like, they label as fake news. Well, guess what? It's not fake news. They're reporting off what they know. The only fake news out there was like that fucking Pizzagate thing.
Oh, man, that's so great. No, actually, CNN, sorry, let me lean up. CNN has been caught numerous times giving fake news. There was a video that leaked of them doing a war during the Desert Storm in front of a blue screen.
Sure.
And then there was another one where they were at a crime scene. And all the cops took down the tape, like the crime scene tape. So they took two poles and put crime tape up in front of the background.
That's still not fake news.
That's pretty.
If you're still reporting on what happened, it's not fake news.
I know, but that's
news,
exaggerated.
Of course it is. I'll give you that.
And then there's another one where this girl's like in a fucking, like, there was a flood that happened and she was in a boat. She's like, record recording flooding here. And she's in a canoe and some guy's walking behind her. Like, it was like an inch of water. And some guy's like, walking in the background.
I mean, yeah, that kind of shit's ridiculous, but it just...
I hate the fucking
They have
news.
To compete with fucking bloggers who get information like that. That's why.
I know, and that's why you have people say stuff like this. Because everyone is so quick on reporting, they're not reporting what's actually correct. And they just
speak
their mind.
Yeah, they report on what they hear.
Yeah, and it's like, so the whole day of age, it's who can report the quickest. It doesn't matter if you're right or not. It's just who reports the quickest. And that's it.
Right.
Like, it's bullshit.
So anyway, we're going to read his quote here. I see being called fake news as the equivalent of the N-word for journalists. The equivalent of calling an Italian any of the ugly words that we have for people of that ethnicity.
Today, Junior.
Words are hard. Shut up. You trip over more words than I do. Oh. That's what fake news is to a journalist. It's an ugly insult, and you better be right if you're going to charge a journalist with lying on purpose. And I agree with him wholeheartedly. But you don't pull out the N-word comment because, of course, you're going to piss everybody
off.
Yeah,
because calling, you know, news reporters have suffered years and years of abuse, death, and slavery. Yeah, it's the same fucking word. What a jackass.
But you know what?
I demand an apology.
Fucking Jim Brewer.
What a piece of shit. I hate the fucking news. Like, what a fucking piece of shit. Like, it's the same thing. And people should be called out for calling you fake news. Well, stop giving fake news and you wouldn't fucking be called that.
But even
so. Over-exaggerated pieces of shit.
Even so, the point he's trying to make is correct. If you're going to lobby or charge somebody with saying that you're reporting on shit fake, you better be damn right. Because that is... insulting a person's journalistic integrity, which is all they got. So if you're going to call somebody out and say you're reporting fake news, you better be damn sure that you're correct about it. Because if you're not, you're just being a douche.
Yeah, and it's just news
in general.
You
can't throw away the N-word.
It's just news in general is bullshit. I've always hated it. News, and this is why news is starting to do like rash shit like this. They're getting frustrated. Like I mentioned this on a show before. The average age that watches the news is like 70 or something. They're losing people.
That's because we have the internet. Why would we want to?
Like, they were going after video games a while, and then it leaked that they were having these meetings saying about how money from video games is taking away money from them. So that's why you see a lot of violence in video games causes violence in real life. Like,
well,
they were caught saying shit about that, and it's like... The CNN and all them, they're all fucking evil. And you think they're trying to do good for the better? They have stock. They are a business.
Yeah,
whatever they want to make money.
It's called sensationalism journalism. Sensationalist journalism. And it's absolutely something that happens. I'm not saying it doesn't. In fact, just the other day, who the hell reported that? USA Today, I think it was, who did that. They had a feature on e-cigarettes, and I don't know how many of you people out there are super familiar with them.
You vape, bro?
You vape, yeah. A lot of people who do the e-cigarette thing, back in the day, they used to drip. And what that is they would take the little cotton-filled cartridge off and just drip directly onto the heating coil and do that for a few puffs. Because back in the day, the cartridges and shit that people used were really finicky. Mm-hmm. Okay, so people started dripping because it was just easier. You know, but you always had to carry a liquid. Most people now just use tanks and shit because they work pretty good.
Yeah.
But they were advertising it just the other day. It was less than a week ago about this whole big thing that's dripping. It's the new thing. Are your children dripping?
I know.
You know, it's like I read it and it's like this is the most ridiculous thing ever. It's the most sensationalist, overblown bullcrap. It's like nobody even does it anymore.
I know.
And you're trying to say it's more dangerous. There's no more dangerous. You're still accomplishing it's the same fucking thing.
It's just like it's like a more difficult way to do it. Like it's like an automatic car versus a standard car. It's the same fucking thing. It's just you do it different. Like it's fucking ridiculous.
And I was reading through the comments on this, and there are enough people who have actually obviously used an e-cigarette for once in their lives or seen somebody who does, who knows it's nonsense. But a bunch of people in the comments were saying things along the lines of, well, if there's something, somebody's going to find a way around it to make it more dangerous and just all this fucking water-headed bullshit.
I know.
It's like, stop believing this crap.
I remember when it first came out, they were trying their fucking hardest to come up with some kind of health thing that it was killing you or something.
The fact of the matter is, it ain't good for you, but it's significantly better.
Well, than I remember tobacco. When it first came out, they couldn't find anything wrong with it. And I was like, and I know the news because of their slimy piece of shit. And I'm like, they're gonna start bringing kids into this somehow. Trust me, like little babies.
Oh,
because
of the candy flavors.
Yeah, I'm like, because anytime the news can't do something, they'll bring kids into it because people have soft hearts for kids.
Think of the children.
Yeah, exactly.
It's not just the news; it's fucking lobbyists and shit. Do you really think R.J. Reynolds wants people to use e-cigarettes?
I know, and that's the thing. I just fucking hate it. And then like a week later. Some little kid got into someone's oil and drank some. I don't even think he fucking
died. That shit will kill you.
Yeah. I don't know if he died or not like that. It happened like once. The whole fucking news lost their shit. See, they're evil. All these kids are dying. And they were saying like all these kids were dying from it and stuff like that. I was like, no.
Well, if you're dumb enough to leave your shit laying around, that's not very smart.
Exactly. And that was the parents' fault.
Yeah.
You know, if it wasn't going to happen with the e-cigarettes, maybe they bought a gun. They'd leave that fucking laying around. It's just the news drives me fucking nuts. Like, one, it happened one time, and I was right. They were going to find something with kids. That's how they do it. And, like, I remember when the Oklahoma City bombing thing happened and the daycare center was blown up. That was, like, a really big part. And they're, like, zooming in on dead babies and shit like that. I'm like, fuck off, dude. Like, you're disgusting. Like, it's just, drives me fucking nuts. Like, they're fucking, these firefighters are in tears because they're pulling out dead kids from a fire. And these news reporters are running up with cameras zooming in on the babies because they know it fucking sells because people have a soft heart for kids. I just felt bad for these firefighters. I'm like, you fucking disgust me. You sick fuck. I never want to hear that I'm the crazy one again. That's about it, though. I hate the news. Go fuck yourself. You fake pieces of shit. You fake news motherfuckers. What are you going to do?
Yeah, but when our fucking president's like calling out and saying fake news when it's shit he doesn't like, that's stupid.
I know, but whatever. I think it's all fucking bullshit.
Thank God we have Trump, though. He provides comedy gold for us for the next few years.
I know, but whatever.
Fuck. I have never seen any president be so disliked so fast.
I don't care. They're all pieces of shit. Whatever. It's
funny.
It makes me laugh. It's all a fucking joke. Whatever. Your life's going to suck. And it's going to suck with the next president. It's going to suck with the next one. And it's going to suck with the
next one. I just think it's hilarious that he thought that he could run the place as a business. And now he's finding out, oh, you can't do whatever you want. There's checks and balances.
Exactly. And that's the thing. Have faith in our fucking government. Stop being a piece of shit and worrying all the time and stuff like that. Who fucking cares if an orange guy, a black guy, or a white guy, or, you know, a grape soda flavor guy. I love how we're referring to an
orange guy as a fucking race now.
Yeah, whatever.
I just laugh because there's a bunch of leaks coming out of the White House. You know, there's been the leakiest administration, like, ever. And it's only been like 20-some days.
Yeah, it's because everyone's so obsessed with hating Donald Trump, which I'm trying to fucking
tell
you. Well,
his own cabinet's the one leaking
it. It's every fucking president's a piece of shit.
Well, what's happening?
You just fucking care for some reason now.
What's happening, I guarantee, is that he's treating his staff like shit, and they're all leaking everything because they just hate him, you know?
Of course they hate him. But he's a fucking businessman. You're not supposed to like your fucking boss. Stop being an emo little bitch.
Well, here's the deal. If your boss treats you well, you tend to be more productive. So I'm just going to put that out there.
Yeah, but then, you know, when you're a lazy piece of shit, you know, and your boss gets on you, what are you going to be like, oh, woe is me? No, you fucking get your ass working.
Mm-hmm.
You're not supposed to like your boss.
But in any event, you know, they've used this rhetoric years over and over again about, well, we need to run a country like a business. It doesn't work.
That's
there's
the whole
why
fucking
they don't
problem.
Do it.
We're already running it like a business. That's the whole fucking problem with the place. Everything is a fucking business in America. Everything. Healthcare, school, everything. And that's why people can't afford shit anymore. God, I'm surprised people can still celebrate Christmas and Valentine's Day for fucking $70 for a thing of fucking roses. That's going to die. Like, you're probably like your relationship anyways.
Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. We'll see you on the next episode of Openly Hostile.
If you have sex tonight, use a fucking condom. Don't want no more kids in this fucking world. Have a good one.
See you later.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.